Hello, this is Areha, and in this video we will talk about who do you want to reroll in Honkai Star Rail. Okay, there are 7 available standard characters and 1 first limited character that you can reroll in Honkai Star Rail. I will explain in a simple terms. Even if you don't have any experience in Honkai Star Rail, you will get a little bit of information about what you are expecting for each character. Okay, there is a brief information about the standard character. Himeko, she's a fire AoE DPS. Weld, he's an imaginary enemy debuffer. Bronya, she's a team buffer. Clara, she's a physical solo sustain. Gepard, he's an ice shielder. Yanqing, he's an ice single target DPS. Bailu, she's a lightning healer. And from the official information about the first limited character, we have Sila. She's a quantum single target DPS. Who should you get? Of course, the primary target here is try to get Sila, if possible. But if you get standard character instead, some of them are worth to keep. From all close beta test I participated, Sila is the most character you can rely on early game even until the end game. She's a single target DPS that has a passive that gain another turn if you kill the enemy. This passive is really good for fighting multiple enemies, even though she's a mainly single target DPS. And not only that, just because she's a single target character, the single damage output will be pretty high compared to multi-target or AoE DPS. I will put her into the character that you should main to get early on. Okay, what happen if you lose 50-50 or get 5-star standard character from the beginner banner? Here is a rule of thumb. Support is always nice, especially healer or shielder, but I will put this as a priority to keep for support. Bronya, Bailu or Gepard, and then Weld. Here are some reasons. Bronya has a full support kit that will support your DPS to the roof in the early game, even until the end game. And the fact that she can swap turn with your DPS character if you use her skill, that makes your DPS basically do double damage for each turn. And not only that, your DPS also can do more damage because it also applies buff to the target. Bailu or Gepard for survivability. In early until mid game, you can just clear content by staying survive. And both characters can do it easily even though we also have 4-star healer or shielder, but these 5-stars just make your early investment as little as possible until you find a time when you want to go all in. So both are a safe choice. Weld is enemy debuffer. It's really good for endgame content, but the target we are looking for right now is to get life easier as possible, and Weld doesn't bring enough value in early game until you reach certain point. And at that time you reach that point, your DPS or support you invested early on will carry you more in the harder content. Or at that point you already have better enemy debuffer. What about Yanqing, Himeko and Clara? Yanqing is a single target DPS. His skill and passive that increase your crit rate or damage will instantly help you early on. But the value of it will decrease at the time your character starts to get invested, like with more gear or level. He's still a really good single target DPS, but I still can recommend him over Sila because of that playstyle. Himeko is an AoE DPS. Her passive is really good to sweep small enemies, especially for farming materials, and her AoE DPS also good with an enough investment. She will help you farm easier in early game and give enough value to keep her if you get her early on. Clara is a solo sustain character. The term is too good, but she lacks solo heal compared to the free character you get in the early game. Yes, I'm talking about the main character. So even though she will help you tank and do just enough damage early on the game, your main character can do the same thing with the price of free. So it's a bit harder to recommend her as a reroll target. Well, I guess I already covered everyone, and here is a summary. Get limited character if possible at this point we are talking about Sila, then try to prioritize support next. Bronya at the best with Bailu or Gepard after. Then Weld last, even though I don't recommend it to get Weld early, especially in a reroll phase, even though he's still good. Then, get whatever DPS you want. Both are really good, either Yanqing or Himeko. And the last we have Clara. I'm sorry Clara. So, I guess that's all the recommendation for rerolling in Honkai Star Rail. Good luck on your reroll. I hope this video is helpful. Give a thumbs up and I will see you again in the next time. See ya!